Today, I'll show you some surprisingly useful features in FL Studio 21 that most of you probably missed. I'm not talking about the major new features like the themes or the audio editing overhaul, which is all we've heard about lately. No, I'm talking about the more subtle but incredibly useful things that make FL Studio so much easier to use. And for some reason, most of it seems to have gone under the radar. I'll also be giving away 3 copies of FL Studio Producer Edition, so if you'd like to get an authentic copy of FL Studio for free, then keep watching. I'll tell you exactly how to participate shortly. As they say, the devil is in the details. If you look closely at the playlist, you'll notice this new plus button. I strongly recommend that you start using it right away. And here's why. Let's right-click on it. Bam! Now we have an audio track, which you can easily record into. Just choose the input and press record. It doesn't get much easier than that. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you left-click on it, then it will create an instrument track. Pick a synth, and there we go. Easy. There are many benefits associated with this workflow. Notice how the name also shows up in the mixer. Now, if I change the name here, it will change the name in the mixer and the channel rack as well. It doesn't matter where I change the name or color now. It will apply the changes everywhere automatically. This is more in line with how it works with other DAWs. Another benefit from this is that you can now just double-click here and it will bring up the VST for you. Notice how it will also automatically select the corresponding mixer track and channel in the channel rack. This goes for audio tracks as well. If you use this method, you won't waste time naming and coloring things anymore. Instrument and audio track has been around for some time, but they are now more intuitive to use. Another small but helpful upgrade is that clips added to new audio tracks are now placed at the playhead location or inside any time selection. This also works when pasting. You can also do it like this. In older versions, it would just pile up like this. You can now also convert to events just by double-clicking on any automation clip and then here. Have a VST that you spent a lot of time tweaking, but now wish that you had made inside Patcher instead? No problem. Just right-click on it and select Patcherize. And there we go. Easy! In the browser, you can right-click and favorite any sample. Click the Tags button to bring up more options. Here, you'll have quick access to all your favorite samples. You can also hold Control and select multiple samples at once, which wasn't possible before. In the mixer, you can now use Control A to select all tracks. You can also turn effects on or off for all selected tracks at once, which is also a big improvement. It's a great feature if you need to temporarily turn off all effects for reduced latency when recording, for example. There's also improved CPU usage, updated plugins, and so on. I'm particularly excited about the sidechain functionality in the new LuxVerb plugin, which is something I'll definitely be using a lot. This was just some of it. Here's a full list of the changes. Make sure to download the latest version, which contains various bug fixes and improvements. Remember, FL Studio has lifetime free updates. So when you buy a copy today, or you already own one, then you can upgrade to FL Studio 21 for free. Now, if you'd like the chance to win a free, authentic copy of FL Studio Producer Edition, all you have to do is leave a comment below and let me know what you're most excited about in FL Studio 21. If there's something that you're not excited about, then let me know that as well. Make sure to include the phrase, "I love lifetime free updates." I'll pick three lucky winners at random, so make sure to check out my community tab and my socials. Remember, any official reply by me will look like this. It will stand out from the other comments here. Last time, there were some fake accounts in the comments claiming to be me and telling people they'd won. Don't fall for that. I don't want to see any of you get scammed by these trolls. Make sure you like and subscribe if you like this video. Perhaps you'll enjoy some of these videos as well. Thanks for watching.